الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها فإن كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين Praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and He's the only one worthy of praise. I seek His help, His guidance and His forgiveness. I believe in Him and I trust Him. I seek refuge on Almighty Allah from the evil of our passions. Indeed, whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides him to al-Islam, no one can mislead him after Allah. And whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put him astray, no one can guide him after Allah. I testify openly that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah Rabbil Alameen. And I testify that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is his messenger and the seal of all the prophets. O Muslims, you must know that the best speech is the speech of Almighty Allah, which is the Quran. The best guidance is the course of the Prophet Muhammad, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which is his Sunnah. The worst of all affairs is innovation and addition to the religion of Islam. Indeed, every addition to the religion of Islam will lead to hellfire. I adjure you as well as myself to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the best of your ability. Fear Allah, have the taqwa of Allah, and don't die unless you are in a state of Islam. We thank Allah and we praise Him for blessing us with this deen. This deen which Allah had chosen and selected. And Allah had told us, إِنَّ الدِّينَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ الْإِسْلَامِ. Indeed, the religion in the sight of Allah is Al-Islam. Everything in Al-Islam is good, and everything in Al-Islam is beautiful, and leads to nothing except happiness, safety, security, progress, everything. This Islam came to give you the good of this life as well as the good of the hereafter. A matter of following, a matter of submitting yourself to the teaching of Allah, to the Sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Today I want to give you a symbol how Islam goes with us everywhere. Anytime you make a turn, right, left, you turn, go straight, you go back. You find Islam have something to tell you. When you eat, when you sleep, when you talk, when you listen, when you laugh, when you cry, anything, name anything. You could not find anything in your life that Islam is not saying something about it. So we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He gave us a full code of life, and Islam became not way of life, but the way of life. In this Surah Al-Hujurat, today, inshallah, Surah number 49, and verse number 6, Allah Almighty is saying, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِنْ جَاءَكُمْ فَاسِقٌ بِنَبَأٍ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِنْ جَاءَكُمْ فَاسِقٌ بِنَبَأٍ فتبينوا أن تصيبوا قوما بجهالة فتصبحوا على ما فعلتم نادمين. One single verse. It gives you security in your life, peace and mind. It makes safety and security between you and your family, between you and your husband, between you and your wife, between you and your Muslim brother in the community, between you and the neighbor countries, everywhere. One single verse. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is calling on the believers. So if you don't believe in this Quran, and if you don't believe in Allah, and if you do not believe that Islam is the best, and Islam is the way and the only way, you could not get this fruit, you could not get this result. One single verse to bring about peace and security and safety between the Muslims, the non-Muslims, the family, the community, the society. But you have to believe, because when you believe, when you know that this man is a doctor, he's qualified to write you a prescription, you will take it. You do not go and question it. You will take it, and you waiting day, 2 days, now I'm going to be well. Allah saying, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِنْ جَاءَكُمْ فَاسِقٌ بِنَبَأٍ. When somebody come to you with information, verify the information. This is the whole solution. Make sure that what you heard, what been said to you is true. This will be the proper way before you act, before you talk, before you start to get emotion and start decide what's going to happen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, oh, you believe. If a fasiq, a liar, evil person come to you within you, verify it, lest you should harm people in ignorance. And afterwards, you become regretful for what you have done. Subhanallah. This is it. If you see what happened, as example, in the time of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he sent one of his representatives to Bani al-Mustaliq to collect the zakah and to bring it to Al-Madina. And this man, he used to have some animosity and hatred between him and these people before Islam in time of Jahiliyyah. So now he is a Muslim, and the Prophet ﷺ sent him as a messenger to collect the zakah. The people were so happy to know the messenger of Allah coming to visit them and to carry their zakah. They came out of the city, out of the village to welcome him. When the man saw the people, he got afraid. He thought about what used to happen between him and them in Jahiliyyah. He saw the people coming to kill him. He did not, the shaitan whispered to him. He make it to appeal to him that these people come to get you. He make it to you turn and go back to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and telling the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the people reject me. The people deny me. The people refuse to give the zakah. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, about he was so angry because those people supposed to be flipped, turning their heels, they did not keep their commitment and their promise with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Here is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam sitting thinking about this matter. Why representative coming from Bani al-Mustaliq say, "Oh Prophet of Allah, your messenger had came to us. We were ready to pay our zakah, but he left before he reached to the city limit. We thought maybe something happened or you changed your mind. We want to make sure that you are not mad on us or something happened." And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was angry with them. And he said that you refuse, you reject. Say, "Oh Prophet, nothing of this had happened." And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had sent the Khalid ibn al-Walid with an army to go and check this information. Wait by the city limit. See if there is any sign of faith or iman or Islam. If so, so come back. Don't bother them. Otherwise, deal with them as it's supposed to be dealing with the kuffar. Here Khalid ibn al-Walid go, hiding and secretly, and they try to watch what's going on. He hears the adhan for Salat al-Maghrib. Later on, he hears the adhan for Salat al-Isha. He came back to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, tell him that those people are Muslims. Those people are still on the Islam, and these people are still practicing what you had taught them. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed this verse. Can you imagine now if the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam went ahead and act upon this information and there start to be a fight and a killing? How many news we hear, especially nowadays. We live in the time of fast media. You have the internet, you have all kind of a channel, TV channels, news, newspaper, and you get it in a minute, in a second, in such a country, in such a place, in such and such. We Muslims, we human beings in general, we are emotion people. And as soon you hear something, this is it. Now you start to carry the information yourself. Now you start to broadcast the information without knowing how. Brother, is my wife told me. Brother, my daughter told me. My daughter going to lie to me? Do not look to people to be Abu Bakr Siddiq or Jibreel coming from Allah. Do not, regardless whatever. There may be something been said and the person misunderstood it. And maybe the person did not mean or did not say the whole thing that because he hear one word. By the time this word come to you, it's not one word, it's five words. because it went from one person to another person to another person. And everybody giving his narration, his addition, the way how he's supposed to present it. And by the time it reached you, now you're already boiling, you're ready to go. Boiling. This is what he's saying, you're ready to go. I'm going to go, I take care of it. I don't want anybody to tell me anything. No. If you have Iman, if you are a Muslim, if you are a true believer, verify the information that had came to you. We even sometimes get information about people saying, the scholar so-and-so said, the fatwa of so-and-so this. Maybe you yourself even have desire of doing such a thing. As a result of this, you looking in a book, or you try to hear, you hear what you want to do. You don't hear what the scholar or the sheikh is saying. And you come back with the conclusion that mut'a is halal. I tried to go to Imam so-and-so to get married, and he did not get me married, so now I start to search it. And now I come to find the mut'a, so sister, you give me yourself for marriage, I give you, you accept, okay, this is it. A year, 2 years, 3 years, and brother, I search the mut'a, nikah. And after this, we are married. Subhanallah. So this is something, safety and security for your deen, for your safety and communication and interacting with people. First of all, try to reach to the source of this information. Secondly, if it's been said and if it's true. Now the second thing you want to try to understand, what is been meant by it. And thirdly, after this, are you ready to actually questioning and try to understand what has been meant by it? But acting and reacting on information without verifying, this is a danger for you in your deen, for you in your dealing with the people, because this is something can harm. And when you harm the people, later on you find the information was not right, you could not redo it, will be too late. So it's better to slow. As the Prophet had told us, al-ajalatu min ash-shaytan. To be hasten and rush is from the shaitan, because he wants you to get angry. He wants you to rush. He wants you to do something about it immediately. But later on he said, brother, I'm sorry. Sister, I didn't. It's too late. It's been done. It's been said. And like I said, nowadays we have this fast means of communication. People put things on the internet. In the fake book or Facebook or whatever you want to call it. And people take it from one to one and continue with things. We have to learn how to verify information. And we need to learn how to slow down. And we need to act and react in a matter of anger in the proper way according Islam, by verifying and making sure that it's been said. And if it's been said, what been meant? And what the possibility that what the person said, it can mean this or that. The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is telling us, كَفَى بِالْمَرْءِ كَذِبًا أَنْ يُحَدِّثَ بِكُلِّ مَا سَمِعَ أَوْ كَمَا قَالَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. It is enough lies for you to repeat everything that you hear. كَفَى بِالْمَرْءِ كَذِبًا. It is a lie that everything you hear it, you're ready to narrate it. And we hear people say, our elders said, the people of knowledge said, but did you know if who are these people? And if this hadith as example authentic or not? Because the worst kind of kathib and lies lying on the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, saying the Prophet said and the Prophet did not say. So it is a great sin. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had told us that whosoever lies against me, let him have his seat in hellfire. You are reserving a special seat in hellfire. Your intention is good. I don't doubt your intention. But the way you went about it was not correct. You have to make sure the prophet said, or don't say, do not talk about it. Because when you tell the people this is sunnah, and this the prophet did, and the prophet said, and all what he said, I was in a gathering. Somebody said, in a book is written, many books. Books became a business today. Writing became a business today. So we have to be careful, especially when it comes about the matter of deen. And people say the prophet said that Islam is about, like here as example, people say Islam and democracy, Islam and this, Islam and modernism. And what do you mean by this? Maybe the person say Islam and modernism, but doesn't mean that Islam about modernism. That mean because we are in the 20th century, 21st, we are in America, that mean we could not, we are not supposed to make salah. We are not supposed to cover. It's okay to deal with usury because Sheikh so and so said. No, we have to be very careful because this is the deen of Allah. Do not lie against Allah. Do not lie against the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And after this, brother, I was there and I heard the imam. We have many imams. We have many sheikhs. We have all what you need to make sure you have the proper information. And what is the person said is meant to this, is not meant to what you came to ask, and you was looking for a fatwa, and this is what she acted and said, the sheikh said, and the sheikh said in the khutbah. Islam is so beautiful. Islam came for our peaceful life and security, and we could not be taking information from a person to person, from family to family, from a mosque to mosque, from a country to country, and people ready to fight, people ready to kill each other because they heard or they overheard. كَفَى بِالْمَرْءِ كَذِبًا أَنْ يُحَدِّثَ بِكُلِّ مَا سَمِعَ. It is enough lying that you talk and repeat and relate everything that you hear. الحمد لله رب العالمين وأصلي وأسلم على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, I would like to say congratulations to all of you. We had started Sha'ban, and by starting Sha'ban does not mean I'm telling you that Ramadan in, because there is something here that we have to be having the Sha'ban in, and we have to be preparing ourselves. Here the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said about the month of Sha'ban, ذلك شهر تغفل الناس فيه عن بين رجب وشعبان وشهر ترفع فيه الأعمال إلى الله فيه الأعمال وأحب أن يرفع عملي وأنا صائم. The Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that this is the month of Sha'ban, which people are neglectful and heedless. It falls between Rajab and Ramadan. And that month, these are presented before Allah. And I love that my deed to be presented to Allah while I'm in a state of fasting. The Prophet ﷺ did not make a whole month fasting other than Ramadan. But he used to fast a lot in Sha'ban to such a degree that his wife said that he used to fast the whole month of Sha'ban. Does not mean 30 days. That means that most of the month the Prophet ﷺ used to fast it. So congratulations that you are in a special month, that you have to start to prepare yourself to observe optional fasting as much as you can, but not to make the whole month. I have a few announcements, inshallah, before I close my khutbah for today. First of all, maybe some of you did not read the bulletin board in the mosque. And there is some rules, about 12 of them. And one of them related to myself, Al-Abd al-Faqir Lillah. That in Friday, you are not supposed to approach the Imam for any needs, wants, especially problems. Marriage, loan. The Imam come and try to focus about what he say, what he want to address the people. He don't want to get disturbed with anything. So we ask you kindly that if you think you have an issue so important to you, approach the Imam in any day. The Imam, alhamdulillah, for 5 salah every day. The Imam, alhamdulillah, every day from Zuhr until 10 and 11 o'clock in this place. So if you want to approach the Imam about something issue to you, not in Jum'ah. Before Jum'ah, my main focus is dealing, talking to the people. After Jum'ah is my feast. I want to see my beloved people. I want to see the faces of Muslims that I don't see them other than once a week for a moment. They want to take the meal and run. And I want to shake hands with the people for a minute, for a second. So please, Friday is my day. Half of it is to talk to the congregation and half of it is to enjoy the other people. It's a break for me. So please, this has been written on the bulletin board. You could not approach me and for your service anytime during the week. I would like to say that about 80% of the student or 90% of the student who attend the summer program, may Allah reward you for your donation, had requested for extension. The children are requesting for extension of the program. Therefore, we're going to extend the BISA program for another week. And we asking you kindly, if you have children sitting home doing nothing, and if you do not have the money to pay it, please bring the child, don't worry. The mosque will take care of it. So inshallah, Monday, we're going to continue with the program, so bring your children. But if Allah bless you and you have the money, please kindly pay your tuition, inshallah. Today, we have a guest. And I wanted to be like a model example or a something to encourage you that you do something for the deen. Those who comes to the blessed breakfast every Saturday. Okay, this is the name of a program. I had talked to you about a sister that I met last month in New York when I went to the conference. And especially for us as men, especially us as young and healthy people, how you need to devote or at least take some of your time and your energy for the deen. The sister today came here to Colombia to visit, to see the mosque, and also to observe the community and to continue with her mission. This is Sister Khadija. She used to be a Hindu. And Allah bless her to embrace Islam. She used to be in a music production. And now she turned to be in Islamic production material. She turned all her life to dedicate herself and her machines, her house, to be a place to produce. She said, I'm not a scholar, but I take the word of the scholars to others. So she makes thousands and thousands of CDs. Every night, every day, her music production been put aside. Even when her daughter got sick, very ill, and she did not have the money. And if she continued with music production, she will have money like she used to have. But she insists to continue with Islamic production, making CDs, and she is not selling the CDs. She go and put them in a table, and for the people to pick up. They put $1, $5, no dollar, this what is she do. And she go to produce more and more, thousand and thousand, every function, any lecture from a mosque to mosque, this what she's doing. She is here today, a woman, this is her life, from Hinduism to Islam. from musical production to Islamic production. Now she have nothing in her life except to make sure the da'wah reach to others. Doesn't matter the Muslims or non-Muslims. I hope that you start by the table today. So you can learn something that you're ready, if you want to do something for this deen, you can do. There is a place in America that you can do something for this deen. And for the people of America, and for the people who live in America.